reform, let me go ahead with the speech variations first. The first PCC-10 by Toastmaster Parrish was validated by Toastmaster Bundy. Can I have the variation?
So Toastmaster Parrish, your objectives mainly was to inspire your audience. However, because you are performing your CC10 speech, so as an evaluator, what I also expect from you as a speaker is that you have gone through all the other speeches and you have successfully taken up all the objectives from the other speeches from CC1 to CC9, and have you taken the ideas and the objectives from those speeches also? Okay, so I'll be talking about that. So firstly, I have to congratulate you for taking up such an interesting topic, because we keep listening about our frustrated job, and we keep listening about Toastmasters. Most of the people give speeches about Toastmasters, or you will listen about jobs, what happens with their bosses. But this was very fresh because you spoke about school days. So here nobody is in school, nobody is in college, but you took us to our school days. So that was very interesting, very fresh, and I personally liked it very much. Then very cleverly you used the prop that you had, the ghanta that you used. However, while you are using the ghanta, try not to speak. So that was one thing you could have avoided, because when you are using that, one sound is already there and then you speak. So that somehow dilutes, and we can't hear your voice clearly. Apart from that, there were very interesting parts in your speech. I would like to talk about that. So you used the example of biryani. So you spoke about three biryanis, three people who can make biryani. One is perfect and he thinks he is perfect. One who always takes responsibility. So in this way you spoke about three biryanis, and then you said replace it with your three kids. So it was very easy for us to actually relate, because biryani example suited perfectly when you helped us try to relate with the kids. So that was very interestingly done. Another thing was you used examples of Madhuri Dixit, Kalpana Chawla and many more. You quoted them. You quoted Kalpana Chawla, what she spoke at university. You quoted Swami Vivekananda. So you had lot of data in your speech. You started with a mother, with an auntie scolding her child that you could not get 96%. You just got 92%. It was a very nice punch there. And you said, if I had got 92%, me and my father both would have gone to coma. So I would say your entire speech was like a masala. So you had sprinkles of all the masalas in your entire speech. You had humor, you had inspiration, and you had very interesting stories in it, and anecdotes which you took from the internet, from the different people. However, if I have to give you one suggestion, I would say if your story can be more emotional, so if you actually bring us more down with your emotional story and then you inspire us, then the impact comes. Because to inspire someone, to take someone to high, you have to first bring them low. So I thought that was somewhere missing, because it was mostly very fun and it was very entertaining. So it never went that low that we could have been brought to that high level. So that's my only scope of improvement, if I could suggest. Otherwise, I personally enjoyed the speech, and I'm sure all of you enjoyed the speech. So thank you for giving your speech, and we would like to see you more here. Thank you.
Adding to what she told, and whatever I'm telling you, it's not just for Parrish, but everybody else. Parrish, first of all, your speech was very inspiring. I have three children, and I did not force them to take a particular course. I left the option open to them, and they have chosen their own paths. Number two, in your speech, it was well crafted, well executed, but the transitions were not good. Take care of the transitions. Somewhere you're jumping from one topic to another topic, one person to another person, without proper connection or without proper transition. Number three, as Varunish told, don't try to impersonate. I could easily find out that you watch some videos of successful speeches of people who have won at the international level, and you're trying to imbibe that style in you, please do. Be what you are, be natural. So, this is, you know, this style of not looking at the audience, looking at the ceiling, or looking at the floor, or looking at the wall, or running back, may be accepted in countries like US or China or some other place, but in India, it's not. We need to maintain eye contact with the audience all the time. At one time, you are looking at the floor and on the wall. So please try to avoid that. This is for everyone, okay? It is not particularly for everyone. Number two, at one part, in one part of your speech, you are speaking while you are walking. See, we shift this stance just to break the monotony. You stand at one place, you tell whatever you have to. When you are moving from one paragraph to another paragraph, or one idea to another idea, just move a bit. Come here, and between when you are moving, don't speak. Then you can continue. That's the right way of doing it. Otherwise, I enjoyed your speech, it was very good. But implement this, and this implementation is for all of you. Watch videos, there is nothing wrong with it, but have your own unique style. It is always people who follow their own style who are successful. Don't try to copy other people. Be yourself. Okay. And the second speech was evaluated by Toastmaster, B.S. Lubbock.